Hi, I'm Scott from Warmly Yours, and today we'll be showing you how to attach a pipe heating cable to a pipe. We have mocked this up here in the office, and even though this is a mock-up, the way that we're going to be showing you to attach it and to wrap it and to get it insulated is what you'll be seeing out in the field. Let's go ahead and show you how to install this cable to the pipe. And the first thing you need to do when you're doing this is to actually get the pipe nice and clean. You want to make sure the pipe is clean so the tape adheres to it very well, and you also want to deburr it to make sure there's nothing sharp on the pipe. Now, in the real world, you're going to put the cable either at 4 o'clock or 8 o'clock if you're looking at the face of a clock. We are showing you this so you can actually see it, so we're putting it out here at the 8 o'clock. However, you should always put the cable on the coldest side. So if this were the wall, which it is, and if this were the coldest side that we need to protect the pipe from, we would actually run the cable at 4 o'clock. So we've got our cable cut to length, and our next point is to actually get it. If this being 9 o'clock here on the face of a clock, we're going to make sure our connection is, where we adhere it, is at 8 o'clock. Attach it there. Now that we have the cable attached to the pipe, what we're going to do is we're going to use this aluminum tape. And this aluminum tape does actually two things. It helps hold the cable closer to the pipe, and it helps spread the heat out. So once we've got it attached with the fiberglass tape, the next thing is to do the aluminum tape. All right, we're going to be attaching the insulation to the pipe. Once again, for the correct thickness of insulation, you're going to want to look at the installation manual. It'll tell you how thick the wrapping you want to do. And as I turn it, I space it so there's always two thicknesses going over the pipe. So I always have overlap. That helps trap the heat, and I have the same overlap every turn. If we're going to be putting this somewhere where it might get wet, we would then wrap it with the included plastic to make this whole thing waterproof. Maybe not waterproof, but water resistant. And we wrap it in the same way, so there's a lot of overlap, and that'll help keep water out of the insulation, because if the insulation gets wet, it loses its insulating properties. Okay, now that we have installed the insulation and the waterproofing over the pipe, it's time to install the warning labels. Warning labels should be placed every 10 feet on the pipe. When you place the label on the pipe, you want to make sure that it's visible from where people will be working on it. So you don't want to put it on the top where no one will ever see it. You want to put it in a visible location out where people will be able to see it. All right, it's time to wrap up our video today about how to install a self-regulating cable on a pipe. We did not cover how to wrap a valve or how to cover a spigot or any specific type like that. That is clearly illustrated in the installation manual. If you are doing self-regulating cable over a valve or over a spigot or something like that, you have to allow for extra cable to be used. That is mentioned and gone over in our installation manual, which you can find on warmlyyours.com. Once again, we did not show how to install a constant wattage cable, because constant wattage cables can never overlap, whereas self-regulating cable, which we've done today, can overlap. And that's why we suggest using it to cover valves and spigots and that sort of thing. So I'd like to thank you for watching today. Have a great day. And if you have any more questions, check us out at warmlyyours.com.